In the beginning, prior to shooting this movie, when I got the script and I was called into audition, I was very fearful of taking on the role because I was afraid that I'd be seen differently. And I've never wanted to expose my body to the public at all. That's why I don't do it in my music or anything like that. But then I took counsel from my dad. We had a conversation and I was like, you know, I don't know. I spoke to him and my stepmom together at home and I'm like, I don't know, you know. And my dad is like, look, if you want to be taken serious as an actor, you have to go outside of yourself. That's what actors do. You can't say you don't want to be looked at as something outside of yourself, because how can you play other characters? You'd be playing yourself your entire life if you were. And so I took on that challenge because I understood where he was coming from. And I was like, wow, I want to act, you know? So I got over my fear in that way because I knew that I had support from the only parent that I had left. He was the only person that I felt, whether he said yes or no, would matter, you know what I'm saying? And then from there, once I got on set with Tasha, she was just like, you know, in acting, you don't judge your character. Because if you judge your character, you won't allow yourself to be vulnerable. You won't allow yourself to be in the character and become that person. You know, there was that, and then there was also this energy of feeling like, you know, through a character like this, I can minister to young women. I could become someone. I could become someone's experience, because this is based on a true story where someone can look at it and say, wow, you understand it. You know, this, when this part happened to you, when that part happened to you in a movie, I can relate to that, whether it's firsthand or it happened to a parent or it happened to a friend, you know. I knew that that would come with it, but all of those things happened slowly. It was a slow process. As I took to the thing and I jumped off the cliff, as Tasha would say, as I jumped off the cliff and just went for it, all of those things started opening up. And performing with such an attractive young man such as Lance, I thought that was the brilliance in him being casted. Because a lot of times people see a film where a villain is casted, and when the villain is casted, he usually this nasty looking dirtbag, and people be like, I don't know why she listening to him. Oh man, I would have been got out of here. You know what I mean? And they make it be easier for the audience to see it as, you know, she could have walked away quickly. You know, but for those of you who watch the film, which everyone in the room today has, you see that. You know, in the beginning, it is slow, it's romantic, it's like, wow, this person, you know, my body, you know, this person is feeling me, you know, and they're giving you the energy that you probably never gotten before. And in this case, Felicia didn't have her father present in the household. So when a man is giving you that much attention, and then on top of that, you're a young mom, and they're coming in to take care of your child that already exists, you know, you don't see what they're doing as wrong when the abuse starts, because it can start mentally and then physically, as we experienced here tonight. And I thought it was very important to cast someone that was attractive.
I think that it helped me grow. It helped me stretch as an artist, as an actor. To be fearful of something before I step into something, and to judge something before I step into it, and then to take counsel from people who have had great success, like Tasha Smith and my dad, and to go outside of what I'm used to, you know? Same thing as stretch, I'm dragging it. But you know, to do that, I think that's where my growth came in, because I got a chance to do, I got a chance to see myself do something that I've never done. And I also got the opportunity to help change lives. I have a sister that's 12 years old. I have a sister that just turned 15 years old. And this story takes place when Felicia was 16 years old. And she served a 3-count life sentence in prison by the age of 19 years old. So this story is so powerful. And I think that stepping into it, I didn't understand how important the role of actually doing a film like this would play in my life. But the more and more I watch it, the more we tour, the more I see, the more it opens up to me, and the more I understand my purpose in doing it. So that's the way I feel I've grown from it. Also, in doing this character, I feel myself to be a very strong person. I'm heavy on communication. I'm open on communication. When I go into something with someone, I always have someone that I talk to and let them know what's going on.
And, you know, I feel like with Felicia, she was alone. She didn't have anyone to kind of go on that journey with her. And she was very vulnerable. And there was a weakness, right? And I had to find where I'm parallel with that character. And what I found is that while I see myself as being this very strong person, right, where I see myself as being this confident person, there's this weak element that we all have, right? Because our strength and our confidence comes in hindsight. That's when we have 20/20 vision. I was saying, you know, it's like, you know, being on your job and you might be in an argument, somebody say something slick like, yeah, and you da-da-da, and then you come back like, uh-huh. But then you get home later and be like, yo, well, I should have said it last week. And wasn't you the same one? Mm-hmm. You need to wash, you know what I mean? You got so much to say because it's like, afterwards you're thinking of, your strength kicks in. Your wisdom, like everything just starts to kick in. The way you see things, the way you see yourself as being a strong person. But in that moment, right, a lot of times we're vulnerable and we're weak. And people say things to us that hurt us in the moment. People do things to us and we don't come back as forceful, as strong as we would want to. Especially in a domestic violence relationship. And so I had to allow myself to be completely vulnerable. There were times when I, like in the scene when I got fucked, I really got fucked. And I wasn't expecting that. Shut up, it's not fuck. So I wasn't expecting that. So I had to stay in character. I had more lines to recite. So I had to now recite these lines like, well, what I'm gonna do about the baby? Like, you know, and I got a chance to really feel, it's not funny. Because I got a chance to really experience what's my feeling. I get it's funny, but it's not funny.
But you know what, it's not funny. It's not funny.
Because I experienced something as an actor that people experience in real life. And when I look back at the character I played, I'm rooting for her, like, do something, say something. But I had to stick to the script as an actor and tell the story the way it happened. And that's what matters. That's the important part, to show women whose experiences that
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you.